We can start. Recording started.
A very
Thank you.
good morning to one and all. On behalf of my management, Dr. Akhtar Hassan Rizvi and Vice President of Rizvi Education Society, Mrs. Rubina Akhtar Hassan Rizvi, Director of Rizvi Education Society, I welcome you all to this online orientation program for what are the undergraduate courses which are offered in our College of Rizvi College of Arts, Science and Commerce. May I now request our principal, Dr. Anjum Arora ma'am, to please welcome the people who are there for this program and the students who are looking for admission to this particular courses at undergraduate level. Dr. Anjum Arora ma'am, principal Rizvi Education of Rizvi College of Arts, Science and Commerce. Ma'am.
हेलो
हेलो मैम, कैन यू प्लीज इंस्पायर अस एंड वेलकम ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर हियर प्रेजेंट फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोग्राम।
यस आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ रिजवी कॉलेज आई वेलकम ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स फॉर दिस ओरिएंटेशन प्रोग्राम ऑर्गेनाइज बाय द साइंस टीचर्स ऑफ डिग्री कॉलेज। आई एम नॉट वेरी हैप्पी विद द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हु हैव जॉइंड बिकॉज दिस इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट्स टू रियली ऑर्गेनाइज सच ओरिएंटेशन प्रोग्राम। But anyway, thanks to those who have attended. The recording will be shared on the website as well as we'll put the link on the group. We have in degree college four major subjects, physics, chemistry, mathematics, and botany, zoology is also. There's a five subjects you can say. Botany, zoology, physics, and chemistry goes up to TY level. Mathematics is there only till second year. Our teachers have taken great effort to show you what are the main benefits of the courses of pure sciences. Nowadays, the trend is slightly that people are more interested in applied sciences at CSIT and do ignore pure sciences, which is the main source of research and development in any country and in any state. If you want any research to be done, any development to be done, then pure sciences is the main background. Physics, chemistry, mathematics, botany, zoology are the courses where students can go ahead and do a lot of things. Many students are unaware of this, and this orientation is basically organized to make students aware of all the basic things which they can do by studying pure sciences. When we were doing our graduation long back, pure sciences were in high demand, and today also the demand is there. There are shortage of people who are there from pure sciences. We have teachers who have all background of pure sciences. Whether you are, even if you want to go into school level teaching, then teaching you should have a physics, chemistry, mathematics, or botany, zoology background to be a science teacher of either physics, bio, or anything. Even if you want to be a teacher in degree college, then also you have to do MSc in these subjects only where you want to teach. Teaching is also one of the good options. Now, I don't want to take much time, but I would really be very happy if more and more students join pure sciences, because this is very, very important and need of the hour. We are lacking behind, and India is also, if you want to become astronomy or if you want to go anywhere in the science field, you cannot ignore pure science. With these few words, I would like Farhana Madam to carry forward. Thank you all the teachers for taking all the efforts in organizing this orientation program, and thank you the vice principal and supervisor of junior college in making this possible. Thanks all the students. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Anjum Arora ma'am. We have with us Ms. Meeta Mehta, who is a vice principal of junior college. Ma'am, can I request you to put a few words on this particular occasion, ma'am? Mrs. Meeta Mehta.
Thank you, Farhana ma'am. Thank you, Farhana ma'am. Am I audible to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
Yeah, ma'am.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Okay. You are audible.
Yes, respected principal ma'am, vice principal, degree college, supervisor, junior college, and all my dear colleagues here, and of course my dear students. Today we have gathered here to enlighten you about the courses which we have for the undergraduate course in our college. Students, particularly science students, they feel that engineering and medical are the two branches which we should go in after the 12th. So they only work for JEE and NEET, but there are many more avenues open after doing your pure science also. सो स्टूडेंट्स नाउडेज फील दैट ओके कुछ नहीं मिला तो हम लोग बीएससी कर लेते हैं फिर देखा जाएगा. नो इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. देर आर मेनी मेनी मोर थिंग्स विच यू कैन डू एंड द लाइव एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ इट इज ऑल वी टीचर्स हु आर वी आर द वंस हु आर मेकिंग द डॉक्टर्स एंड द इंजीनियर्स. वी आर द वन हु आर ट्रेनिंग देम. वी आर द वन हु आर हेल्पिंग देम आउट. यू नो टीचर्स आर द बिल्डर्स ऑफ द नेशन. सो टीचिंग इज वन बिग प्रोफेशन यू कैन टेक ओनली इफ यू हैव डन प्योर साइंस. सो यू कैन बिकम अ साइंस टीचर. यू कैन ऑफकोर्स बिकम डॉक्टर्स एंड इंजीनियर्स बाय गोइंग इन टू दैट लाइन. बट देर आर रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट फील्ड एंड यू नो नाउ विद द कमिंग टेक्नोलॉजी वी रिक्वायर पीपल हु विल बी डूइंग मच मोर रिसर्च इन दिस फील्ड. So we definitely would want that the more and more people go into the different lines such as physics. We have maths. Now what about biology and all? Yes, that is again one important field that your people intend to ignore, which you should not, because there is a lot to be done in the. We have now combination of courses also which take place even after the graduation level. If you go to the university, you realize that there are so many different things you can do even after taking biology and whatever zoology or biology. You require good people into those fields, which people are not going into, and they are ignoring this field. So if you go into these things, definitely you can do something in your life. It is not that okay if you have taken BSc you are nowhere. So please you try to understand whatever the presentations our teachers are doing. Our degree college teachers will be helping you out. We will be putting up all these PPTs on our, as discussed, we'll be putting up on our website, as well as we will tell the students also. Once again, we will put up the numbers of the teachers who can help you out, who can guide you. But do not get disappointed or dismayed that we have got less marks. No, there are students we have seen in our, I've been here in 33 years and I've seen that there are students who have done their BSc, but still they are doing much, much better than the doctors and the engineers. I have seen doctors and engineers without job. So if you are, they are just doctors, they are not earning that much. But there are people who have done their BSc and they are doing much, much better than the doctors and the engineers. So please see, and there's a lot of amount that for becoming a doctor, for becoming an engineer. So please try to see your own potential and accordingly select a line which is better for you. This is something which I want to say. There is much, much more in pure science, not just because probably you're not aware, you don't take in pure science. But please, if you go through it, you will be enlightened that there is something still there waiting for you other than doctors and the engineers field. So try to understand it and try to make a best choice for your own self. Remember, you are an individual. You are something different from the others. You are different from that whole 6 billion people who may be there in this planet. So try to see that you are born with a purpose. You have to do something different than the others. Don't follow a trend like a sheep that others are doing medical, others are doing engineering, so even we have to do that. Try to see what is best for you, what is best according to your potential, and then try to follow that particular line. So I wish all the best to all my students here. Make a proper choice for yourself after going through the presentations. Do the inquiries and then select the field. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you all who are present here and taking all the efforts to enlighten our students, or those who have prepared the PPT and those who will be sharing it with our students. Thank you, all of you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Meeta, ma'am. Meeta ma'am is the vice principal of junior college. Now can I request Miss Haseena Sheikh, who is the supervisor of junior college, to say a few words, ma'am, and inspire your students to look forward to this PPTs. Haseena Sheikh, ma'am.
Haseena ma'am, please unmute yourself.
Respected principal Dr. Anjum Ara Ahmed, Vice Principal Meeta Mehta Madam, and all the degree college teachers and my dear student, good morning all of you. First of all, I would like to congratulate all the HSC pass students. They have all science students, they have passed this year. So maybe they will be preparing for the NEET and JEE. But I just want to say that NEET मेडिकल एंड इंजीनियरिंग के अलावा और भी बहुत सारे कोर्सेज हैं, बहुत सारे ऑप्शंस अवेलेबल है आप लोगों के लिए. यू कैन डू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग बिसाइड द इंजीनियरिंग एंड मेडिकल. हम लोग सोचते हैं कि 12 के बाद अगर मेडिकल इंजीनियरिंग नहीं हुआ तो कुछ नहीं होगा लाइफ में, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. बियॉन्ड दैट ऑल्सो देर इज अ स्कोप. आई कैन गिव यू वन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ माइन दैट आई हैव डन बीएससी एंड एमएससी. इन एमएससी वी वर सिक्स स्टूडेंट, we were six students, three boys and three girls. So we three girls, they are in the teaching profession, and the three boys, they have done MSc by research and PhD. One of them from the TIFR, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, and now he is in USA. And one boy, he has done MSc and PhD in Institute of Reproductive Health. That is in front of KIM hospital. So, and he is also placed as a junior scientist in the reproductive health organization. So they all are absorbed and we all are working and we are doing better in the field after doing the pure science. And after the botany and zoology, I'm a zoologist, so I'll be little biased. So the chemistry and physics teachers don't feel any offended. Because after doing the zoology, you also go for the paramedical courses. There are a lot of paramedical courses after the zoology BZ. If you do, then in DY Patil also, they are offering a lot of the courses and placement. Nowadays, you know, there are a lot of placement available in the paramedical courses. So after doing BSc, you can do the 1 year or 6 month paramedical courses and easily they get the placement in many medical hospitals and the private labs. They are offering jobs in chemistry and physics also. If you go, you will get the good opportunity in chemistry. The chemistry teacher will tell you about it, that what are the option available, and for physics also what are the option available. So you can make your career in pure sciences also. It is not like that if you are not getting in medical engineering ke life khatam ho gayi, ab kuch nahi hoga, aise nahi hai. इसके बाद में भी बहुत कुछ आप लोग कर सकते हो, अपना करियर बना सकते हो प्योर साइंसेज लेके. और प्योर साइंसेज में अगर रिसर्च में जाते हो, टीचिंग में जाते हो, इट इज वेरी गुड. आई एम नॉट टेलिंग कि हम थ्री गर्ल्स अगर टीचिंग में गए तो ऐसा कोई ट्रेंड है, ऐसा कोई ट्रेंड नहीं है. द गर्ल्स ऑल्सो कैन गो फॉर द साइंटिस्ट दिस रिसर्च एंड ऑल, दे ऑल्सो कैन बिकम द साइंटिस्ट. सो इट इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर इंटरेस्ट. इफ यू हैव इंटरेस्ट इन द this research area, then you can go for it. If you have the interest in the medical field, then you can go for the paramedical sciences also after doing the BSc. Okay, so whatever you do with your full interest and your full dedication, then definitely you can make the career in pure science also. Okay, so I wish you all the best, all the students, for your future, and thank you very much. Thank you, Farhana ma'am.
Thank you, Haseena ma'am, for that motivating words. I think it is now time for us to start with our PowerPoint presentation. And before we start with the PowerPoint presentation, may I quote, it is said that anything is possible when you have the right person there to support you. Believe me, my friends, believe me, my students, that you have the world's best management, a team of best teacher, the best principal and the best of the vice principal, a best infrastructure, a very good library to support you. You have everything here at RISVI. And therefore, we thought that we should go for a PowerPoint presentation. May I now request the Department of Mathematics from Department of Mathematics, Farhad sir, to give the presentation. Farhad sir, are you ready with the presentation?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, please start.
Good morning, one and all. I am Dr. Farhad from Math and Stats Department. My presentation is the importance of studying mathematics. On behalf of my colleague, our in charge principal madam, our HOD Arunachalam sir, I am giving you the idea that how this mathematics subject is important in our life. So first of all, since we are trying to come to the pure sciences, it is said that mathematics is a mother of all sciences. That's why when you are going to study all these four subjects of pure sciences, the first of all, everyone must know the basic concepts of mathematics. Some of the examples which are here on the screen, that basically if you go for physics, chemistry, then biological sciences, computer science, information technology, for all these subjects, mathematics is a base. One cannot say that without having a basic knowledge of mathematics or undergraduate courses of mathematics, I can go for all these subjects. Over and above this, you can see that nowadays, statistical analysis is an important tool used in all the fields, including the commerce, including all professional courses, including all the fields of government institutes. Everywhere, all the conclusions or all the decisions are made on the basis of statistical analysis. And the other subject which is related to this is a data science, which has a wide range and applications of statistical analysis. So if you go for the pure sciences, mathematics is a very important subject. Just to know more about the mathematics other than these core subjects, I will give some idea that if you go for anywhere in a banking system, if you want a job in a banking system, knowledge of mathematics is very much required and preferable, and it will give more weightage to your CV if you have the knowledge of mathematics, you have done mathematics up to undergraduate level. Anywhere if you go for banking system, you will see that all that loans, deposit, repayment schedule, EMI, fixed deposits, everywhere you need the basic knowledge of mathematics. Normally, people ask the question that whether why should we study mathematics, whether it is useful in our day-to-day life. See, all my friends, all these things, everywhere, it is related to our life only and where mathematics is applicable. Nowadays, we cannot say that I am not related to computer and I don't want computer anywhere. When we pick up our mobile phone, it is a computer only. It is a computer applications only. It is software only. And for all these purposes, there is a need of mathematics. Everything behind all these things is mathematics. So to understand the computer applications, to understand the calculations based on computer, we need the computer software and knowledge of the software which is related to mathematics only. Moreover, normally when we study mathematics, some of the topics we teach up to higher secondary level, and students are more confused that why we should learn all these things, why should we study all these things. Let us take the example of linear programming problem. You must have studied linear programming problem at 12th standard level. So nowadays, if you see in commerce, the optimization techniques are used. Every businesses are using this technique to optimize their business, to optimize their profit. And for that, they use all this linear programming optimization technique. Even in the forecasting also, in the company's future outputs, they use the forecasting techniques, which is nothing but the optimization or maximization technique. So that is the purpose that we teach linear programming problems at that level. Then come to the another very important, but normally people think that why should we study derivatives, or in general, why should we study calculus, integration, derivatives, differential equation, etc. Other than the pure sciences, this calculus or derivatives and integral calculus is used many places in commerce and industries. Like that, there's some examples here I have given, that monitoring rate of change of commodities, maximum or minimum value of the data, marginal cost, marginal revenue, elasticity of demand. Everywhere, all these techniques of calculus are used. Then you take the case of permutation combination or number theory. Many topics are there. You might be knowing that the number theory is used in a crypto cryptography, and cryptography is the part how these all the messages are sent through all that mobiles and how the coding is done. For that purpose, number theory is used. There was a time that people used to say that we are studying number theory, but there is no use at all. But now in a wide application of this cryptography and coding technique, number theory is being used. And one example of that is permutation combination. And these all important application which we can understand. Normally, I'm giving you the example which you can understand easily. In the databases, data mining, operational research, opportunity theory, everywhere these permutations and combinations are being used. Continuing this, you go for broker firm, demat account, etc. All mutual fund company, everywhere the mathematics and particularly statistical applications are being used. If you ask me the future prospects, if I go for mathematics, you can see there is a list of at least 10 different things I have quoted here. Even if you go for the clerical job in the administrative field, or even you go for managerial skill or professional skill, you need mathematics. If you go for banking firm, insurance firm, corporate houses, industry, accountancy firms, you will be preferred over any other candidate since you are knowing mathematics well. And that's why mathematics is very much needed. If you want to start your own business, you are going for entrepreneurship. If you are going for teaching and research, no doubt teaching and research is a major thing which we can go after mathematics. Students can do MSc, PhD, NET, SET, but that is true for all other science subjects such. If you go for competitive exams, you will see that mathematics is a part of every competitive exam. And you will do better in that if you know all these undergraduate mathematical courses. This is the thing just I want to say. I will request all the students that don't leave mathematics. If possible, as and when possible, you try to learn. It is not like that if you are studying mathematics and you are not scoring well. That is a different thing. But at least if you are going through all these courses, you will get many different benefits from that. This is what I want to say. Thank you. Thank you very much. I have done, madam. Hello.
Next person.
Parad sir, thank you very much. Can I now request Dr. Abhay Ranade sir, who is the head of physics department, to start with his PowerPoint presentation. Dr. Abhay Ranade, sir.
Thank you, madam. Good morning. Hello. Thank you, Parana, madam. Am I audible?
Hello. Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir, you can share the screen, sir.
Thank you. Good morning. A warm welcome to everyone. Principal Madam, Head of the Department, my colleagues, and of course, a special and a very warm welcome to enthusiastic and the most talented dear students. Dear students, you see that present era is a very competitive and very challenging also. My one simple advice to you all, do not overestimate the competitions, but at the same time, do not underestimate yourself also. Self-trust is the first secret of the success. Ambition is the first step to success. And the second step is action. In brief, today I'll take this opportunity to explain the various activities, co-curricular activities and job opportunities for those students who are under graduating with physics as one of the subject.
Ranade sir, please give your presentation.
Hello.
Sir, share your presentation.
Yes. Hello.
Yes, sir, Hello. You can go ahead.
Okay. Department of Physics. Physics is one of the most important subjects in your undergraduate course. The department was established in Rizvi College of Arts, Science and Commerce in 1989. First year BSc, the physics was introduced in 1989 itself, and henceforth SYBSc, the second year BSc in 1990, and the first batch of TYBSc, where six students flourished out with first classes, it was in 1996. Dr. Abhay Ranade is the founder of the physics at graduate level. We have four teaching staff in the department in the form of associate and assistant professors with their degrees. They have various field interest in classical mechanics, pure science, electronics, instrumentation, and so on and so forth. At FYBSC level, you can offer physics along with chemistry and maths. Or Rizvi College offers a second group at first year BSc level, PCB, Physics, Chemistry, Botany. At first year, semester 1 and 2, you have two physics papers. SYBSc, third and fourth semester, student can offer only two subjects, either physics, maths, or physics chemistry. These two groups are offered by our colleges. Of course, there are other options, but they are in other colleges. At SY level, you have three physics papers, and last but not the least, at TY, that is your fifth and sixth semester, it is a six unit course where you will have four physics major papers and one applied component, that too physics. So a student under graduating with physics has six papers at TY level. Department make use of various ways to make the subject interesting, clear, and student friendly using various ICT tools, videos, sharing, websites for different lectures, and actual visualizing virtual experiments. The most important thing that physics department do is periodical tests and assignments. We also give opportunity to the students during the lecture that they have to present the seminar to build a confidence, to build a subject knowledge, and reduce the fear of presenting the subject physics. Problem solving session, being a physics subject, you cannot avoid, but of course group discussion helps you out to solve the problems and to reach the root level of the problems. The one important thing about the physics department is that we do conduct parents meet. In the parents meet, regular assessment of a student is being informed. Bridge course we always conduct when you finish FY and you are likely to take the admission at SY or from SY to DY. This course helps you out to refresh the back semester's portion, as well as we throw a light on next year's next semester syllabus which you are going to do. As I said, many times we do experimental teaching to make the concepts of electronics, mechanics and optics user friendly rather the students friendly. Various seminars we conduct, personalities, scientists from TIFR, Nehru Center, we always invite them to impart their research knowledge, their institutional knowledge to the students. Financial help to the needy student is always an important thing that our department does it. Yes, department also has a social responsibility, and very efficiently this social responsibility is being carried out from years and years. And one responsibility that we have shared is nothing but raising the awareness of the cancer, prevention, right time detection and right treatment is required, and we always arrange lecture for the students so that they can spread this awareness among their community. Various activities that Department of Physics do undertake every year. As I said, ERA is a competitive examination ERA. You have various examinations like JAM and JEST. Department of Physics is very happy to say you that we do the teaching for JAM and JEST. Various field visits have been arranged, and one of the most interesting and the fascinating to see the universe, various objects through telescope by having an overnight sky observation. It is remarkable to see the Jupiter's moons, rings of the Saturn, and various telescopes that are used. Various workshops also be arranged. We participate in inter and intra-collegiate activities, in various science exhibitions, poster presentations. Along with your curriculum and teaching and your scientific development, the department also sees that you get the importance of values, rights, duties and various other seminars that we arrange on various social economic activities. These are the few activities which you can see the department has conducted. Anuja Kode is an international boxer and a karate player. She has done her graduation in physics with 67%. See that she was a gold medalist in international and national, and being a physics student, she knows how to apply the Newton's laws of mechanics. How she has understood the Newton and the Kepler. That is why she could win the medals. On visit to Nehru Planetarium, distinguished guest lectures, and we also appreciate the students when we do take the various seminars of the students on the various topics assigned to them. As I said, our regular 14 February is our date where we celebrate the Cancer Awareness Day. This day and date we don't miss. That is our social responsibility that we do carry, and we do get support from management, principal and all my colleagues and all my students to do all these activities. Other issues, this photograph you can see, a visit to metallurgical lab, and various industries that we have visited so far, good reputed industries where the students get a knowledge that why physics is required at graduate level, or why it is so easy that you can pursue your career with BSc and can be absorbed in such reputed companies. These are the activities, as I said. Social issues also we do take into consideration, that the students' overall personality development is one of the important criteria that we look for, and therefore we celebrate the birth anniversaries as well as the other days like Kisan Day, Energy Conservation Day, and so on and so forth. Yes, these are our students who have achieved. As I said in my last slide, that we do coaching of JES and JAM, and he's a student, Mr. Prathamesh Mishra, has secured All India rank 148 and also cleared exam, a toughest exam, Viva interview and written exam at TIFR. Mr. Nitesh Yadav has won the third prize at international conference at SY level. The student was at SY level and he won the third prize in nuclear physics, the international conference which was held in Himachal Pradesh. Sachin Dubey is a recent example of our TYBAC student who was selected in IUCA, a famous institute for astronomy and astrophysics at Pune. Anjum Madam rightly said that the best and the noble profession by pursuing your career in pure science is a teaching. We have various students who have passed out from our college, done BSc with physics 6 unit major, did PhD from either TIFR or from ICT Mumbai, and now they are working as assistant professor in Thakur College and other institutes. Dr. Praveen Pawar, Dr. Sandeep Kumta, and Mr. Irshad Khan was the ex-faculty of Rizvi College, Department of Physics, of course. Mr. Mohammed Surbi, 2 years ago, he graduated from physics and now working as a professional pilot in Pawan House, Mumbai. Amay Nagvekar is also software consultant in L&T, Pawai. Anuja Kode, as I said, has established her own coaching institute. Various career opportunities that students can have after pursuing your graduation with physics. I have listed few of them. Actually, there are many more. One of the best and noble profession is the teaching. Research assistant in various government and non-government and semi-government sectors, the DRDO, TIFR, BRC, ONGC, never-ending list. If you want to be the scientist in BRC, TIFR, you have to have MSc with PhD. Then you are absorbed at C level, B level and A level as a scientific officers. Lab technicians, of course, medical and non-medical industries is the high requirement where a physics graduation with physics, electronic instrumentation and applied component knowledge is highly necessary and required. Radiologist, forensic expert, radio officers in aviation, Indian Army, Navy, so on and so forth. You have various competitive exams, qualifying exams of all these institutes where a graduate student from physics, maths, chemistry can apply and will be easily absorbed in these institutes or government or non or semi-government sectors. Our two students have already doing SY and already joined Indian Railways and MTNL in the due course. Sound engineering is one of the most outstanding in field waiting for the physics graduate students. Of course, as I said, career opportunities with physics are never ending. I have to constrain myself. Software industries, Infosys, Wipro, L&T, TCS, they need a graduate from physics, maths, for development of various softwares. Solar power plants, automation industries, various issues where you can see the need of physics graduate students are there and you have your bright career in all these fields. Of course, conditions are applied everywhere. You have to simply have a knowledge of this. With this, I will thank each one of you, especially the students. Please go through the presentations and do a proper right selection of your career. We believe that success doesn't come to you. We believe that success doesn't come to you. You have to got to go to it. You're getting this? Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Abhay Ranade sir, Dr. Abhay Ranade sir. Thank you very much for such a beautiful presentation.
Thank you.
Now it is a turn for Department of Chemistry. I myself belong to the Department of Chemistry. I am Farhana Khalidwali here, heading the Department of Chemistry. It is said that chemistry is life. No chemistry, no life. May I now invite Dr. Jaffrey, who is supposed to be one of the most dynamic personality of our Department of Chemistry, to give the PowerPoint presentation on our behalf. Dr. Jaffrey, sir, please present Department of Chemistry.
Yeah, thank you, madam. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak over here in front of the, my colleagues and the future students of Rizvi College of Arts, Science and Commerce for the BSc faculty. Now, students, I am over here to talk about BSc as a course. Basically, students think that there is no light after 12th if you don't get admission in engineering or medicine. That is not the end. अगर आप वहां पे सक्सेसफुल नहीं हुए फॉर वन और द अदर रीजन इट इज नॉट द एंड अगर उतनी ही मेहनत द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ एफर्ट इफ यू पुट इन बीएससी आई गारंटी यू यू गेट अबव 90% आई गारंटी यू द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ एफर्ट विच यू हैव पुट इन 12th स्टैंडर्ड यू कैन एक्सेल इन बीएससी इट्स नॉट इट इज जस्ट एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ 12th स्टैंडर्ड सो ओवर हियर All my colleagues who have said before regarding mathematics, physics. Now I am going to speak on chemistry, and later on you will hear from botany and zoo as well. Now all the fields are equally important. You cannot just give any numbering to any particular subject. It depends on your interest. Whatever interest you find, like you are good at, you should proceed with that subject. Now, over here, I'll just give a glance of what you can do in chemistry and how much you can achieve in chemistry by doing BSc with chemistry. Now, basically, this is a bachelor course of 3 years, which is done after 12th standard. Now, in BSc, we have physics, computer science, all different subjects are there. In Rizvi College, we have physics, chemistry, mathematics, botany, zoo and chemistry, and physics, chemistry and botany. We have three different combinations. Now, why you should choose chemistry? Now, over here, I'll be talking about splitting this topic into three. One, for those who want to go for teaching. Then second, those who immediately want to go for job opportunity after doing BSc. Thirdly, those who want to excel in chemistry, or they want to excel in science, I should say. So let's see, over here we have got chemistry. If you take a base of chemistry, then there are a lot of options which are available to build up your career. Now, basically, chemistry jo hai aapke har field mein use hoti hai, whether it is nuclear physics, wahan bhi chemistry use hoti hai, whether it is botany, whether it is zoology, everywhere chemistry is being used. One more thing is that chemistry student, they get an analytical mind because they have a combination of everything. Because this thing, particular chemistry field, is applicable in all the fields. Now we have got, after BSc, you can go for Masters in Science, MSc, and Diploma. I'll be speaking about this also, postgraduate diploma and certificate courses. BSc as application is clinical laboratories. You must be going to laboratories where you go for blood checkups and everything. Blood reports where you go for blood testing. Then you have got forensic labs. You must have seen in CID. That involves chemistry. Lots of it. Then you have got cosmetics industry. You have got perfumes. You have healthcare. Then we also have in military hospitals. We have energy firms. You can see solar energy. Then you have got textile companies. You have pharma companies. Means a lot of it. You can find chemistry in basically all the fields in every walk of life. Now we have got a number of institutes where you can go for. Now I am talking about the research. Those who want to go, those who want to excel, those who want to become scientists. Now this is with chemistry as well as with physics, with botany, with zoology, or with mathematics. Anything. You can be employed in BRC, that is Bhabha Atomic Research Center, which is you can call the backbone of India's nuclear activities. Then you have got TIFR, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, then IIT, then TIS, that is Tata Institute of Social Sciences, then NIT, CSIR, then you have ISSC, the Indian Institute of Sciences, then your Homi Bhabha National Institute, JNU. Then there are a lot of it. There are a number of research institutes where you can pursue your research activities. Yeah, if you have an aim like Abdul Kalam, you want to become a scientist in your life, you want to achieve something great, then you can go for this. And that is possible by going through BSc. Then we have chemistry in the field of fertilizers and petrochemical refineries. Means you can see chemistry is like finds a vast application throughout the industries and throughout our life. Whether you talk about fertilizers, like we can call it about farms, then we come into our city. If you come into city, everyone uses paints. So you've got paints industries, Pidilite industries, Shalimar paints. There are a number of paints industries which are there. And I'm not just saying like this. Our students have been like employed in these companies. They've got jobs in these companies. So you can see, now we have got pharma companies as well. So you can see chemistry has a wide application across the industry, across the field, like whether it is fertilizers, whether it is consumable product, or whether it is paints industry, pharma industries, everywhere. Means if you are a chemistry graduate, I am guaranteeing you cannot be unemployed. Okay, we have got Nivea. These are the companies where students get employed after doing BSc with chemistry. Now, MSc in chemistry, now those who want to pursue their teaching career, they can choose MSc as well, and they can stop their MSc. After doing MSc, they can stop, they can go for B.Ed. It's a 2 years course. They can become a teacher, or just by doing MSc and B.Ed, they can just by doing MSc, they can also be employed in degree college. So MSc is a field where if you don't want to study much further, you can stop at MSc and you can get a job opportunity in teaching. Also, by doing MSc, you can also, if you don't want to pursue, you can go for some small PG diploma courses, certificate courses, and then it's a very short-term courses, hardly minimum 6 months and maximum 2 years courses are there. It ranges from 6 months to 2 years. So you can do this short-term courses and you can be employed. Students, I would like to tell you that nowadays, merely doing graduation is having no importance. Even those who are doing engineers, they don't get jobs until and unless they do MBA. So even I would recommend you, if you want to go for some managerial post, go for BSc. Why you want to go for the engineering and then go for MBA? Do BSc, do MBA, and then you can get into a good company and across the field. Now, because you have already done your BSc with chemistry, so you can be employed as a manager in pharma industry, in cosmetic industry, in fertilizers industries, in refineries, oil refineries, in abroad also, it has wide application. You can get into a number of companies. So this is about MBAs, you can go for MBAs also. Students with science backgrounds are preferred in MBA. Then you can also go for Masters in Computer Sciences applications. They just require a graduation in any field, whether it is chemistry, whether it is physics, or whether it is mathematics. Now, why I say chemistry? Because chemistry has a base of mathematics as well as physics, and that is being implemented in analytical chemistry, where you learn all the three topics in one field, that is analytical chemistry. Now, what are the courses which we offer at undergraduate level? We have got FYBSC, SYBSC, TYBSC, which are over here. Now, anything which is possible when you have the right person there to support you. Now, why this saying has been put over here? In Rizvi College, as sir has also said before, that we guide students. आपको जो नॉलेज चाहिए, आपको जो इंफॉर्मेशन चाहिए, वी हैव अ गाइडेंस सेल एंड ईच डिपार्टमेंट, वेदर इट इज केमिस्ट्री, मैथमेटिक्स, बायोलॉजी, बॉटनी, जूलॉजी एंड फिजिक्स, वी ऑल टीचर एज वन यूनिट, वी गाइड स्टूडेंट्स इन वॉट एवर फील्ड दे आर गुड एट एंड वॉट एवर इंफॉर्मेशन दे वॉन्ट टू नो रिगार्डिंग एजुकेशन, रिगार्डिंग पर्सुइंग देयर एजुकेशन फॉर फ्यूचर. सो वी इवन हैव अ गाइडेंस सेल वेयर वी कैन गाइड यू. Now we are in a department, we have got a number of professors, we have got very well experienced teacher, our HOD, that is Farhana Madam, Farhana Khalid Wali, Dr. Rajesh Masurkar sir, expert of organic chemistry, myself, Dr. Jaffrey, Dr. Damarwala, who is also a expert in physical chemistry, then Ms. Sheba, she is our student. Now we have our student joined, she has just done 2 years back BSc from our college. Now she has been employed as a teacher. So even you have a scope of going into teaching after doing BSc and pursuing MSc, you can become a teacher. If you have vacancy, we can employ you in our institute as well. So we have highly experienced teacher. These are the, now you even as such, you are a part of the RISVI Education Society. You are there in the college. So I think so. You must have already witnessed the ICT-enabled teaching, which is being installed in each of the classroom. We are using computers. We are using slides. We are using PowerPoint presentation for explaining. We have got a good team of teachers who are there as a mentor to guide you. We have got counseling cell who counsel the students according to their needs. These are some of the activities which the department has carried out. We have got activities like tie and dye, where we teach the students tie and dye. We have art of making chocolate. Then we have about, this is candle making, how the candles are made. Now these are done in order to enable you to become an entrepreneur so that you can start your own business, like making chocolates. And we have students who have started their own business after learning this. We have got students who have started with this candle making jobs. They have started as their own business. Now we have a number of alumni. Now the very first name over here is Dr. Siraj Ansari. He is a scientist in BRC. He is our student and he has become a scientist. As I said, those who have want to become scientists, they can become scientists. Those who want to become a manager, they can do some courses after doing BSc and going for MBA. And there are certain short-term courses after which you can be employed in companies. We have these are the companies which are there, where our students are working. Someone is in Dubai in a bank. Then we have got Senior Nestle. Then we have a Genpack. We have got Guardian Perfecto, Abbott Manor. You know, these are, you can just read it. The list goes on. So there are a number of companies, whether it is bank, whether it is industry, across the field, a chemistry student can be employed. So chemistry is very, very helpful in getting jobs after doing graduation. And one more thing I would like to say lastly, that 12th is not the end, medicine is not the end, and engineering is not, there is a world beyond that. Think about it and go for BSc. And you will find it really that you have taken a right decision. Thank you all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jaffery, sir, for such a wonderful presentation.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. And can I now invite Sabha ma'am from Department of Botany Zoology to give her presentation?
Am I audible?
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes. Yes, yes.
Very good afternoon to all. Now, with the permission of my head and head of the institute, I like to present now earlier PPT you all have seen, sir has explained very well that how can we take admission in BSc. But now if your requirement is same for the plain sciences, that same, that is, you must pass the 12th class in science stream and they must have the physics, chemistry and biology in their 12th standard. Now, if you want, as I am presenting here, BZ, so if you want to take admission for BZ, you must take admission in FI BSc CBZ course. That is, now admission is based on the cutoff which is released by the university or the college. Now, when we talk about admission, so FI BSc, if you have CBZ and thereafter in SY, you can take admission in, there are many combinations in our college, but I have listed which can lead to the BZ only. So you can take CB, you can take BZ, you can take CZ, but the student, those who all have taken BZ, they will only be promoted for the TYBSC BZ course. Now, why TYBSC BZ? After doing the TYBSC BZ, you have a great scope. You and me, if we are going for and we are doing any course, we are pursuing for the purpose of the job only. So after BSc, if you are doing, as sir has told in the previous slide, that until unless plus graduation plus is a requirement. So if you will do some paramedical courses, professional course or post graduation, so that will be very helpful. So after doing the TY BSc BZ, you can get admission in MSc. Now BZ ka basic benefit and most important thing about BZ is that you can do MSc in botany as well as you are eligible to do MSc in the zoology subject. Now after MSc, we can go for the PhD program. Now we have the PhD in RISVI also. The PhD program basic requirement is we must have the entrance exam. It may be conducted by nationally or it may be go by the university level. So there are many other entrance exam also which are required, basic requirement for the PhD entrance. Now top specialization in MSc, after you have done your graduation, now you want to do or you want to go for the further studies. So there are many field in MSc, many courses you all can take, like biomedical. First I will talk about the applied sciences, like biomedical science. You can go for the ecology and evolutionary biology, animal behavior and neurobiology. You can go for the cell and developmental biology. You can go for the general botany. General botany includes many courses, taxonomy and all. And general zoology, as I am from the zoology background, I have made a separate video and about the courses into the zoology. I will share the link of that video. But right now, the time does not permit me to talk about that. Now we can go for the genetics, then we have the marine biology, PhD in botany and zoology. Now PhD is one of the most important degree we offer, PhD in botany as well as the zoology subject. We have the 5 students till now, those who all have completed PhD in the botany subject. 3 students have registered for the PhD in zoology subject as well. As I told you, the basic, your and my aim for doing any course or any graduation is the job. So we can go for the teaching job. Now I will not discuss much about the teaching job because Jafri sir has explained it in detail about teaching jobs. Now after doing BZ, you can go for the forest service. There are entrance exam. Detail of these courses I will not go in much detail. I have mentioned the website. This PPT will be shared with you all students, so you can go on the website and you can get the details of these courses. Then pharmaceutical industry, we have a good scope after doing your BSc BZ. Then we have job into the research government sector as well as the private sector. You can be a discoverer, everybody's dream. Tourism, a wonderful job. Then you can go for the breeding. Breeding is one of the field of the animal husbandry, and it is a very, very economic field and most leading nowadays. Then animal husbandry, CIF is the Central Institute of the Fishery Education. Yeah, if you will just Google about CIF, you will get lots many job opportunity. Are there lots many courses they offer which you can do after you're doing TYBSC BZ. Then animal care and the food preservation. Then you can go for, if you will do this diet and nutrition after BZ, then you can go for the animal care, food preservation, many companies are there where you can apply. Then I'm not just talking that these many jobs are there. Really, we have the student, those who are well placed after doing graduation from us teaching. College teaching, we have Dr. Alkama Fakki. He is our student who has done HSC to PhD from Rizvi College. And now he is our colleague. He is working as assistant professor in botany department, as well as he is member of Help Yourself Foundation. And you imagine HSC to PhD, such a great job he has done from the Rizvi. Then we have many other professor, Dr. Smita, Firdaus Ansari. They all are placed in the, now you all can see the name of college. So they all are placed into the very well known colleges. Then we have many school teachers. We have just selected few students, but list is really very big. Now Dr. Wasim Sheikh, he is practicing doctor in alternative medicine. He is a chief medical officer at Sai Baba Hospital. There are many other our students, those who all are working in a very good hospitals, Cooper Hospital. Then we have students, those who all are employed into the Kokila Band, then Leelavati Hospital. So we have many, many students. The list is really very high, but time does not allow us to explain. Now, see, other than this basic subject, teaching, then your paramedical, we have students, those who all have placed in other places. As you can see, Akash Jha is the bank deputy manager. Now, many other classes of employment also, you all can see. Samiksha Bhavat, now she is going to foreign for her further study. She is a content writer. Then many students, they all are placed into the Air India also, and they are working, they are caring about the health department of Air India. We have students, those who all are working into the travel company. Thank you very much. From my side, this much is over. Now I will share the link which I have prepared for the courses of the zoology into the chat box. Those who all are interested definitely can go. Sorry. I have mentioned this link into my PowerPoint also. So this PowerPoint will be available to you all on our website. So students, I prepared courses in zoology or separate video because of the shortage of time. I cannot explain in detail about so many courses. So just go on that link and must watch that video. Thank you very much. May I now request our head of the department, Dr. Ansaria Rana, to propose formal vote of thanks.
Thank you, Sabha ma'am. On behalf of Rizvi College of Arts, Science and Commerce, I take this opportunity to express my gratitude and heartfelt thanks to our management, our patrons, respected President Dr. Akhtar Hassan Rizvi, and Director Madam Advocate Mrs. Rubina Akhtar Hassan Rizvi for giving us this opportunity to organize such an insightful orientation. With a heart full of veneration, I would like to thank our respected principal, Dr. Mrs. Anjum Ara Ahmed, and Vice Principal, Junior College, Ms. Meeta Mehta, for embellishing this occasion with their sheer presence and support, giving life to the orientation. This Thanksgiving would be incomplete without thanking our lovely students and head of the departments and the presenters, without whom today's orientation would not have tasted success. Considering the restraints and limitations this pandemic has posed, a special thanks to our Professor Javed Pathan from CS Department for giving all the technical support and guidance for smooth conduct of the program. Thank you once again for your time and patience. Have a great afternoon.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
You can ask questions.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your great efforts. Thank you so much.
You all want to say, ask anything, students? बच्चे नहीं लेंगे पीछे तो सब mostly चले गए. कान पर या you want to ask anything?
No, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
No, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, then conclude. हो गया. Everyone has finished their presentation. Saba.
Yes. As per the schedule, everybody has finished.
Madam, can we conclude the program now?
Yes. Please conclude.
So we are finished with the PowerPoint presentation, and it's now time to say you goodbye and conclude this particular session. Hope it was very enriching to all of you. We have a very small request on behalf of all the teachers here. Please wear your mask, maintain your social distancing, remain at home, please get vaccinated, and also do some short-term courses online which are available to enrich your knowledge in this pandemic. Thank you so much for being a part of this particular program. Thanks a lot and have a very good and a wonderful afternoon. Thank you and God.
Thank you, ma'am. You too. Stay safe.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, beta. Thank you. God bless you all. Thanks a lot for attending.